Hey gang, how's it going? My next project that I got to take care of is the rear wheel seal and clean up the brakes on this F700 dump truck. It's got the Lucas Girling brake system on it, which is kind of a joke. I'd never even heard of them until I had the pleasure of dealing with this thing. I've already done the right hand side, so I figure I'll show you the left hand side, what it takes. The right hand side was kind of a learning experience for me, so, but let's jump on into this thing and you'll see what it takes to do it. Like I had said before, this has a brake system on it called Lucas Girling. And I have to say, the name right there says it's a big old cluster. So, but they have this spring brake right here. You have to cage the spring brake, and that relieves the pressure off the brakes. So, that way we'll be able to get the drum off and everything. But you've got this center caging bolt right here. I was gonna be smart, bring a impact, or which actually I brought the impact. It wasn't smart enough to drag the hose with me. It's just out of reach. So sorry. It's coming. It's going to take 5 minutes longer. Now we're starting to get some resistance. Way these things work is there is a spring in there that whenever there's no hydraulic pressure in this line right here, that spring activates and expands and it pushes a wedge out, and that wedge is what spreads the wheel cylinder inside and applies pressure on the brakes for when you're parked. I wish I brought that air hose. Oh, we're at the end. So, this chamber right there is that caging bolt. So as you technically remove the bolt, screw it out, it's taking a spring inside this chamber and it's pulling it out and pulling that wedge out. And now the tire turns. Before I wouldn't have been able to turn that. It'd just been totally locked up. these Dayton wheels, you're supposed to use something as a reference because of the way that they mount up and install with the wedges. You can get them out of whack pretty easy. So you're supposed to use a component that you can set square on the ground, and as you spin the wheel, if it's out of whack, then it's going to reveal itself there, and you have to adjust accordingly with these wedges to true it back out. Alright, so we're closing in on the very end of this project, and I don't know if you guys will be able to see this very well or not, but I figured, because I have to be on both sides of this axle, the front side to adjust the brakes, and then the back side to uncage the spring brake here, so, I don't know how well you'll be able to see this, but I figure I'll try to show you the best I can anyway. But this is what I do. I have two creepers. Say, that's the first time I've done that, and I didn't lose a boot. Again, here's that chamber. Oh man, that's the wrong daggone size on the ratchet. Maybe that's just my luck. That's terrible. That's gonna be the fifth time I've had to come out from underneath there. Hold that thought. Alright, I'm back. For some reason, I've been ignorant today. Usually, I'm always very prepared because it's no good having to come in and out, up and down, up and down, up and down, and putting that much more wear and tear on my shoulders than I really have to do. But for some reason today, I don't know if it's just because I'm so excited that I'm at the very end, but I just didn't really feel it. I don't know. I've just been ignorant today, I guess. I want to stay out in the cold longer than I needed to. So, anyway. Uncage this chamber, which that is actually the parking brake mechanism. It'd be so much easier if it pipe wasn't in the way. That one's done and tight, which means that thing should be locked. Oh yeah, there it is. I still need to fill the diff fluid and uncage this other one, but I don't think you guys need or care or want to deal with that and watch that, so we'll just go ahead and kill this thing off right there. But same old story, song and dance. If you like this, thought it was entertaining, thought it was educational, thought it was stupid, whatever, be sure to give it the old thumbs up, like it, subscribe to my channel for more whatever all this is. But until next time, have a good one.